Hello, my name is Natalie. I'm one of the engineers that works on Google Web Designer. And in this video, we're going to take a look at how to create animations using the Quick Mode Timeline. The Quick Mode Timeline is one of two animation tools that we have. A lot of files will open in this mode by default. The other tool is the Advanced Mode Timeline, which you can access by clicking this toggle button in the top right-hand corner of the timeline panel. And we have a separate tutorial which will focus on advanced mode specifically. And in this one, we'll just talk about quick mode and some things that you can do with it. Let's step through an example. I have this list of buttons, and let's say that I'd like for them to fly in one by one from the left side. So the first step is to position them where I'd like for them to be at the beginning, which is off the page on the left side. Then I'm going to click this plus button down here in the timeline panel, which will add a new scene after half a second, and this is something we'll be able to customize later. In this scene, I'm going to rearrange my elements the way I want them to be at a half a second in the animation. So I want just the About button to be visible on page. And then so on and so forth. A new scene to have the Gallery button fly in from the left side, and a third to have the Contact button fly in from the left side. And so now we have an animation. You can verify this by clicking each of the thumbnails, which will show you a preview of what the animation looks like at that point in time. Or you can also click the play button to get a live preview of your animation on stage. And this little loop button will let you loop preview repeatedly so you can debug your animation. So as we saw, the 0.5 between every pair of thumbnails represents the duration between every transition between every two scenes. If we click this, we can customize this duration to be longer or shorter. Let's say I want this one to be 1 second long. And we can also adjust the easing. So this is the Bezier curve that's used to compute intermediate values for all the animations between every pair of scenes. So we have all the standard CSS easing functions available. You can cycle through them one by one. So ease in out is a good one, as it simulates real world motion pretty well. So if we preview now, we can see that the transition between third and fourth thumbnails uses the ease in out transition and takes about 1 second. So this is an overview that should hopefully get you started with building some animations using quick mode. It's pretty simple to use, but there will be a limit to some of its capabilities for very complex animations. So for example, if you've got many elements that are animating concurrently and you want to be able to edit each animated element's keyframes and transitions individually, if you want to create things like custom easing functions or be able to add interactivity, those are all things for which you'd need to venture into the advanced mode timeline for. And we have a separate tutorial that goes more in depth into that. That's it for now, and thanks for watching.